Today on BRStv Reef FAQs, we answer, how high should I mount these lights? It's not what you've been told. Hey, I'm Ryan with BRStv Reef FAQs, a resource for quick, straight to the point answers and realizing that dream reef tank. Today, how high do I mount these LED lights on my reef tank? I'm gonna tell you right now, forget most of what the manufacturers have told you because it's probably wrong for your tank. This is a challenge all of us have run into, and it's hard to know what the right answer is because the advice or instructions are often conflicting. That's because every single tank is different in size, shape, depth, what's in it, the lights themselves, and how they're used. There is no one-size-fits-all answer. So today, we're gonna give you a quick, easy-to-use method that you can adjust to your tank and desires. With a human eye and a bit of intuition, everyone can find a near-perfect mounting height for your individual tank and lighting solution. Keep in mind that mounting height does have an impact on maximum PAR, but most people use the sliders and knobs in their lights to adjust PAR intensity. Mounting height is more about the spread and even distribution of light, which is arguably more important. So the first thing to note is the opposing forces at play here. The higher you mount the LED lights, the better the spread and quality of light will be. Meaning with every inch that you move the LED lights up, it will reduce PAR hotspots, increase spread, reduce shadowing, blend the spectrums of the individual LEDs better, and get closer to that even blanket of uniform spectrum light that we're looking to provide for the reef tank. However, the inverse of that is the higher you go, the more spill you get into the room. Meaning rather than entering the tank, the light is illuminating the floor, wall, or anything near the tank. These lights are not cheap, so the idea of half the light not even entering the tank is not just visually unappealing in the room, but also expensive and inefficient. This is something you can see in our BRStv Investigates, where when you raise the lights up, the distribution always gets better and more even, but the average PAR across the entire tank always drops. So where's that nexus or balance of these two things for you, and how high should you mount your lights? First, I'd use the manufacturer as a general guideline, but after that, it's more about your tank shape, and how close you put your lights is more of a personal priority than anything. There are two common priorities. The first is I'd like to light the tank in the most efficient or economic manner, meaning purchase the fewest lights possible and consume the least amount of energy possible. Assuming you picked a light with the light spread or footprint that matches your tank, the goal in this case is to get as much of that light into the tank and as little into the room as possible. So that just means raising the lights up until there's signs that there's significant spill onto the wall or room. You might not get perfect distribution this way, but that might not be required for your desired tank. For instance, LPS, Softy, Zoanthid, Mushroom, and even some mixed tanks with well-placed SPS are just less dependent on providing perfectly blended blankets of difficult-to-shadow light. However, the other common priority is lighting the tank in a manner which maximizes the spectral qualities of blending the individual spectrums, distribution of light, and benefits of that even blanket of PAR. More often than not, this is often related to a wall-to-wall SPS tank where corals shadowing themselves and their neighbors are a big issue. Almost every long-term epic SPS tank puts a ton of attention into an ideal lighting solution. In this case, I'd just say raise the lights until there's an unacceptable spill into the room. For instance, WWC hangs their LEDs anywhere from 16 to 24 inches off the surface of the water on their displays. This is done with light distribution, even intensity, reduction of hotspots, and spectrum blending in mind. Not maximum efficiency or lowest initial cost. The concept of raising and lowering the lights based on an acceptable coverage and spill into the room isn't groundbreaking, but it's way more useful and actionable advice than a generic answer of 8 inches for any size, shape, or type of tank. One caveat to this is with LEDs, you can use multiple smaller light sorts, spread them out over a larger area, and run them much closer to the surface with many of the same benefits. We did an investigation with the AI primes a while back, which shows the PAR distribution from a single row of AI primes to multiple rows, and in the end, I think this is one of the installs with a nexus of reasonable economics and ideal performance met. All this data was part of the evolution of everything that we've learned about lighting a reef tank properly. In fact, I think this year was one of the biggest leaps forward that we've made. The Reef Tank Lighting Made Simple and Stable episode of the BRStvWC Hybrid Method was easily one of the most inclusive, easy to follow lighting episode that we've ever done. Particularly if lighting an SPS tank is on your mind, I guarantee that you'll learn something that benefits your tank. See you next Wednesday with the next batch of BRStv Reef Facts.